Sanam Padmakaru Divahu Padma Duti Sapta Turangavahu Divakaru Luka Guruhu Kiriti Mai Prasadam Vedhatu Divam Om Ye Shure Sahasrishu Tejrasu Jagatpati.
Hi everyone, so I'm at the foothills of the Himalayas in northern India, and it kind of made me start to think about Himalayan salt. So we all know that there's this new fab about eating different types of salts and the minerals that it contains, and also there's tons of salt caves nowadays and salt baths and different types of salts that are available for us. And it kind of makes me think, well, salt we know is really, really good for us, in moderation of course. Salt is actually necessary for maintenance of proper blood pH, fluid balance, muscle functioning, body temperature. It's very important for athletes in terms of hydration, and the list goes on. But doctors say to kind of keep your consumption down. I'm assuming they mean through fast food and processed foods, because unrefined, unprocessed salt is actually really essential to the human body. So at the end of the day, when you go into the hospital, the first thing that they do is they hook you up to an IV. And IV is saline solution, and saline is sodium, so it can't be all that bad for you. And I guess the quality is extremely important as well. So for example, if we take white table sugar versus unrefined, unprocessed, freshly pressed and dried sugar cane, there's a big difference between the two. But just going back to Himalayan salts, did you know that most of the Himalayan salt is actually made in a Kura salt mine? So it's not actually coming from the Himalayan mountain range. It's coming from a little town called Kura, about 300 kilometers away from the mountain ranges. So we're kind of getting a little bit gypped. It shouldn't even be called Himalayan salt. The other thing about it that's very, very interesting is that they claim that Himalayan salt actually has about 80 plus minerals in it. But how true is that? There's actually been quite a few lab results and analyses done, and it actually says that they've only found 31 minerals that could actually be detected through their machines. So does it have 80 plus? I'll leave that up to you. In terms of salts, obviously table salts, we've got a lot of additives in there, and there's a lot of processing that they've done. So they actually process it at extremely high temperatures, stripping it away of all the good stuff. Whereas you're left kind of with not much. But if you go for different types of salts, for example, we'll go with the pink stuff, the Himalaya salt, or Celtic salt, volcanic salt, there's even bamboo salt, there's tons of different salts. And if you go for ones that are unrefined and unprocessed, you'll be able to find ones that have a little bit more benefits to you. But at the end of the day, do your research and see what's best for you.